Good afternoon, friends. Hope I am audible to you and visible to you also. The examples we were taking yesterday for same we are continuing today for the groups unit 7 from the second section of DMS. Am I audible? Yes, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Have all of you got your marks? I see one marks.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We waited for more than 10 minutes then also. Participants are very less. Let it be. We will start. The example yesterday we have seen is this one, like set of all non-zero real numbers is a group with respect to multiplication. Okay, then the properties a group possess that we tested for this set, that is R star set of all non-zero real numbers. In that very first property was closure property. In that the multiplication operation we have taken. So product of any two non-zero numbers is again a non-zero real number, and that exists in that R star. So here the closure property is possessed by this R star. Okay, then the next property is associativity. Associativity is again the property, means if three numbers we are given, then result is same for two sides when the order is changed in case of multiplication. Okay, means A, B, C are the three numbers. Suppose I multiply A and B first, and multiplication of A and B is again multiplied by C. It's same with multiplication of B and C, and multiplication of B and C again multiplied by A. It does not change the results. So this R star set possesses the associativity also in the, with respect to multiplication. Then comes the identity. Identity is the unique element through which the operation performed gives the same result. Okay, means suppose one is the identity element in that set of all non-zero real numbers. Means what? The multiplication of any element with one gives that element. Answer of that multiplication will be that element. So what we come to know that one is the identity element there. The next property that we have to test is inverse property. Inverse property, real numbers are again also contain the decimal numbers also. So inverse means what? Suppose A is the number, its inverse is 1 upon A. And that is also, it belongs to that set, that is set of all non-zero real numbers. 1 upon A also belong to that set. So we can say that inverse property is also possessed by that R star. Okay. Then next comes is the commutativity. Commutativity means what again? If A is multiplied B is same as B is multiplied by A. So we can say that this R star, that is set of all non-zero real numbers, possess the commutativity also. For the first four properties, we come to know that it is a group. And when the fifth property, that is commutativity, comes in the picture, we say that if a group possess the commutativity also, then it's an abelian group. Okay. For the first four properties, that is closure, associativity, identity, and inverse, if these four properties are there for any set, then it is a group. But if the fifth property is there, that is commutativity, then that set is known as abelian group. Then that group is known as abelian group. You got this difference? Yes. What is this group and what is an abelian group? Tell me, anyone, what is a group and what is an abelian group? Yes. Am I audible to you or not? Yes. Vaishnavi. Division A, roll number 14, Vaishnavi, Mandvi. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, anyone, please tell me the difference between group and abelian group. Who will tell me the difference between group and abelian group?
Abelian group satisfies a commutative property where group does not.
Group, what? Who was this? Unmute yourself again.
Yes, ma'am.
Praveen. Roll number 40, division A. Did you tell the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And what are the four properties that are possessed by the first group?
Closer inverse identity.
And
associated.
Okay, if these four are possessed, then that is a group. And if additional commutativity is possessed, then it is the
abelian group.
Yes. All of you get this? Yes, all of you get this?
मैम असोसिएटिव आहे म्हटलं कम्युनिटिव असलं असणारच ना कम्युनिटिव
गुड क्वेश्चन बट नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर जस्ट अ मिनिट Good question. I will really work on this and take the example on this. Okay. Who was this? Please tell your name. Yes. Am I audible now? Connection is unstable. Good question. Associativity and commutativity are two different properties, but it's not always necessary that associativity and commutativity means belong to the same concept all the time. Okay, we'll tell you example for this. Sure. In the upcoming lectures, we will discuss it, okay? Then the next example we had taken was this set of real numbers R is a group with respect to multiplication. But R star, it was a set of all real numbers without zero, that is all non-zero real numbers. But when R is there, that is a real number set, zero belongs to it and the multiplicative inverse of zero does not exist. The inverse property is not possessed by this group. Means it's not possible to take an inverse of zero, that is 1/0, we know as it is a infinity, we cannot define it. So this is not a group. R is not a group. R is what? It is a set of all real numbers and it is not a group. But set of all non-zero real numbers is a group. Okay. Then the third example we had taken was for this, let Z and star be an algebraic structure where Z is set of integers and the operation star is defined by n star m is equal to maximum of nm. Okay, then what we have to show is it is a semi-group. Then also we have to take as is Z star is a monoid. We have to show that. Okay. Then A, B, C, we have taken any three integers. Then closure property. Is this property is possessed by this set, that is Z is the set of integers. Okay. Integers means what? Again, -1, -2, -3, and 1, 2, 3 means there are positive and negative integers only, not decimals. Okay. Now A star B is the maximum of AB. It belongs to Z for all A comma B belongs to Z. Maximum of AB means it will be either a number A or B, and AB belongs to Z. So answer or the operation performed on this also belong to Z. So the closure property is possessed here. Okay. It gets satisfied. Then associativity. Associativity is also A star B star C is maximum of A, B and C. Okay. Is equal to A star B star C. It's also equal to maximum of A, B, C. And it also belongs to Z star. So this one, that Z is where the Z is set of integers, this associativity is getting satisfied there. So for a semigroup, what our criteria is, it should possess two properties. Those are closure and associativity. Okay. The name itself suggests. Okay. For a group, we have four properties, closure, associativity, identity, and inverse. Okay. And for abelian group, we have commutativity also. But as its name is semigroup, for a semigroup only two properties are there. Which are they? First is the closure and second is the associativity. Okay. And when a monoid is there, identity property is added to the semigroup, then it becomes a monoid. Otherwise, not. Okay. But the difference between again semigroup and group, semigroups we have studied in the last unit and groups in this unit. So again, I have added these examples to this unit so that to get the clear idea of the concepts. Okay. Semigroups possessing two properties, closure and associativity. Groups possessing the properties, closure, associativity, identity and inverse. If a semigroup is again possessing identity property, then it is called as monoid. If a group is again satisfying the commutativity, then it's an abelian group. Okay. Then we'll see here. For the identity property, for this Z, that Z is a set of integers, there is no integer X such that A star X is equal to maximum of AX. Maximum of AX, what it is the operation given, this one, the star operation is this one, maximum of this N into M. Likewise here, A star X is maximum of A comma X is equal to A for all A belong to Z. Okay. So what we can say that identity element does not exist because there is no such integer X such that a star x is equal to maximum of ax is equal to a. We cannot say that in this operation that a is always the greatest one. Okay, x for that matters, x should be small all the time. Okay, but it is not the case. It gets varied. It is not unique. What the identity property is there? If the element, such element is unique element, but this uniqueness is not possessed by this x. So the identity property is not get satisfied with the with this operation for the set of integers. Okay, so we can say that hence this z star is not a monoid. Okay, z star is not a monoid. It is a semi group, but it is not monoid. Okay, got this?
Yes, ma'am.
Then this example also we have seen. Set of all positive rational numbers, and the operation given is AB by 2 here. Huh? Then if let A is equal to set of all positive rational numbers, the set taken here is A. Okay, then let A, B, C be any three elements of A. Then we will see for the properties one by one. Here we can say that closure property. We know that product of two positive rational numbers is again a rational number, that is A star B belongs to A for all A B belongs to A. Okay, got the closure property. Here star operation is multiplication. This one A B by 2, multiplication of A and B divided by 2. Okay, now we'll see for associativity. Then here A star B star C is equal to what? A B is A B by 2, A star B is A B by 2 star C. Then what about this one? This one star C is there, so again we will take it in this form. It will come as ABC by 4. Okay, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Same is the case with this one. A star B star C is equal to A star BC by 2, and again taking this operation for this term, it will come as ABC by 4. So this operation is associative also. Then we will go for the next property, that is identity element. Okay, let E be the identity element. We have A star E is equal to AE by 2. A is the any element of that set A. And A star E, star here is, we know AB by 2. So A star E, we can write it like AE by 2 for the given operation. Okay, AE by 2. Then by the definition of star again, A star E is equal to A. because what we know is means operation performed with yeah, that identity element or unique element gives the answer that element only. Okay, so what we can do is we can say is this A star E is equal to A. Okay, then since E is the identity element from 1 and 2, what we have is this one. A E by 2 is equal to A. It gives us that E is equal to 2 and 2 belongs to A. So 2 is our identity element. Okay. A E by 2 is equal to A. A gets cancelled. E by 2 is equal to 1 and that is therefore E is equal to 2. What we get is E is equal to 2. Okay. So here identity element exists and 2 is the identity element in A. Okay. Did you all get this? Identity element exists and 2 is the identity element in A. Now for the inverse property. What about the inverse property? Let A belongs to A. We already have considered that small a is the any element of capital A set. Capital A set is again set of all positive rational numbers, means 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, let us suppose B is inverse of A. Okay, let us suppose B is inverse of A. So what we have is again A star B is equal to AB by 2, which is the given operation. Okay, A star B is equal to AB by 2 and A star B is equal to E is equal to 2. Okay, means what? Here A star B is given. It's not by definition. And here what we have supposed is B is the inverse of A. So for the inverse property that we know is when the operation is performed between element and its inverse, the coming answer is the identity element. Okay, that is equal to E. This one A star B is equal to E. And that we have evaluated to 2, that identity element is 2. It is by definition of inverse, we know, because here B is the inverse of A. Keep it in this mind. Let us suppose B is inverse of A. Here B is inverse of A. So A is multiplied by 1 upon A, that is inverse of that A is equal to E and is equal to 2, because we know that E's value is 2. We have evaluated it. Okay. So from 1 and 2, what we get is AB by 2 is equal to 2. Okay. So B is 4 by A. B is equal to 4 by A. Belongs to A, which belongs to A. It is a positive rational number. 4 by A is a positive rational number. So it belongs to A, and from that we can say A star is a group. Okay. And for abelian group, what we say is commutativity is A star B is equal to A B by 2 is equal to B star A is equal to B A by 2. Okay. So commutativity is also possessed there. So we can say that A star is an abelian group. Okay. Got this example?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we will go for the next now. In a group, G star prove that identity element is unique. Okay. Now, G is any group, star is any operation. What we have to prove is identity element is unique. Then we will go by reverse process. Okay. What for the proof, what we have to assume here is, let E1 and E2 are two identity elements in G. Okay. Suppose those are two identity elements in G. Now what we have there, E1 star E2 is equal to E1, because E2 is the identity element. We can cancel it. Again, E1 star E2 is equal to E2. Since E1 is identity, we can write it like this. E1 star E2 is equal to E1, and E1 star E2 is equal to E2 also. Okay. So from 1 and 2, what we have is E1 is equal to E2. Yes or no? We can write it like E1 is equal to E2. So what we come to know that identity element in a group is unique. It doesn't have any other any other identity element. In each group, there will be only one identity element that will be unique. Okay. The next example we have is in a group G star, prove that the inverse of any element is unique. Okay. Now, for the inverse of any element is unique, what we have to do is, let A, B, C belongs to G, and E is the identity element in G. Okay. Let A, B, C belongs to G, and E is the identity element in G. Let us suppose both B and C are inverse elements of A. Okay. What we have to suppose is B and C are the two inverse elements for a single element A. Now, A star B is equal to E. Since B is inverse of A, we can write it like this. A star B is equal to E, because we know when the operation is performed between an element and its inverse, it gives us the identity element. So what we can write it like this, A star B is equal to E, and A star C is equal to E, because C is also inverse of A. B is also inverse of A, and C is also inverse of A. So what we have is A star C is equal to E. Again, A star C is equal to E. From 1 and 2, what we have is now A star B is equal to A star E, C is equal to E. RHS are same, so LHS would be same again. A star B is equal to A star C, and by left cancellation law, what we have is again B is equal to C. Okay, A is common, it gets cancelled. So what remain is B is equal to C. So what we come to know here again is, in a group, the inverse of any element is unique. In a group, identity element is unique. In a group, inverse of any element is also unique. Okay, you got this? Now, the next example is this one. In a group, G star, prove that A star B inverse is equal to B inverse star A inverse for all A, B belongs to G. Okay. Now, see here, what we have to do is, G star is a given group. In that, inverse of that operation between two elements is equal to that elements are inverse there again, means B inverse star A inverse is given. Okay, so here we have to consider is A star B inverse star A inverse. Okay, by associative property, what we can write here is this one. What we will do is this one. A star B inverse star like this, A star, B inverse. Okay. Means what we are doing here is, we are changing the order of all these elements. Okay. What we are doing is, A star, B inverse, star, A inverse. We are changing the brackets only. What we are doing here, A star, giving again bracket here, B star, B inverse, bracket complete, star, A inverse. Okay, A raised to minus 1 here, you can get this. This is written as A inverse. We will probably use whiteboard for this. See here, what we have to prove, what we have is A star B star A inverse star B inverse. Okay. Then by associativity, what we did there, A star again in one bracket B star बी इनवर्स एंड नाउ अगेन स्टार ए इनवर्स. Got this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just by associativity. Okay, by associativity. Okay, now what we can do is again we'll see. Just a minute, where is my whiteboard? I'm not getting. We are up to this one, A star. B star, B inverse and A inverse. Okay. Now what we have to do is again inverse property. Okay. By inverse property, if we use the inverse property, what we get is here we know B and B inverse, it is equal to E, that is identity element when we use the inverse property. So what we can write it like A star E star A inverse. We can write it like here again is because we know identity element, operation performed with identity element gives that element only. So what we can write it like here, A star A inverse. Okay, is the identity element. Identity element performed operation gives that element only. So we can write it like A star A inverse is equal to E again. Because element and its inverse operation is there between it element and its inverse. It gives us E. Okay. So by inverse definition, it is by inverse definition, then it is here like by identity element definition. Okay, so what this become as A star B star A inverse star B inverse is equal to E. Okay, it became as E. Now we have to take second, that is RHS also. for that, what we have to prove is for that, what we have to prove is here again. Not a problem. What we have proved here is A star B star A inverse star B inverse is equal to E. Okay. Now what we have to prove is A inverse star sorry, it's B inverse. B inverse star A inverse B star A. Again, with the same associativity law that we have studied, we can take it like A inverse here we can write it like this, then B inverse star E star B again, because this inverse property A inverse star A, it's equal to E, that is identity element. Again, what is B, what it becomes is B inverse star B. So again, it is equal to E. Okay. What we proved is again, LHS is equal to RHS. So we can say that this one, A star B inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse for all A, B belongs to G. Okay. Both the sides are coming is equal to E. We already have, means just now we have solved this one also, B inverse star A inverse. Okay. Means what we have done is, this one is solved and this one is also solved. So both the sides become as E. So we can say like this, we have proved this. This one, A star B inverse is equal to B inverse star A inverse. Okay. Then is the next lecture instruction is there? Okay. We will stop here because you have a quiz and that is to be solved up to 4:30. We will see it in the next lecture. Okay. Tomorrow's lecture.
students.